Hello students, today we are going to discuss about cloud IAM. We will be briefed about what exactly is cloud identity and access management, what are the various parameters which are essential to know in order to understand this concept of cloud IAM. So let's start a discussion on the cloud IAM. IAM is basically stands for identity and access management, which basically deals with three aspects: who can do what and on which resource. So who could be any kind of person or a group of person or any application. Can do what basically deals with the specific actions or the privileges which are assigned to the who part of the IAM. On which resource means that specific resource, being it a compute engine or an app engine. So who can do what on which resource is the full-fledged meaning about a meaning of the identity and access management. Before understanding in brief about the cloud IAM, so here I have presented the six objects which are essential to know within the IAM model. So there is the very first one is the organization, then folders, then projects, resources, roles, and the last one is the members. So before understanding this entire particular objects of the IAM, let's discuss about the cloud hierarchy first. Here is a resource hierarchy, which depicts that there is one example named as example.com, which is representing the organization node here. So like we know, in any organization or enterprise, there exists a one organization node. So one person, maybe a CEO, who is looking after the entire management process of the enterprise. So example.com is acting as a root node or the organization node here. Below example.com lies the two departments, which are the child of the example.com. So one organization which is acting as the parent can be having multiple child nodes. So these child nodes are described here as the folders. Folders could be any, like in order to simplify our management process within an organization, we can generate n number of folders depending upon the size of the organization and the operations that we are going on. Furthermore, the folders are further been divided into the small entities named as the projects. So here in the department X, it must be dealing with some sort of the work over there. So I have provided that bookshelf is the work that is been done by the folders. So folders are further been divided into the projects, or you could say that department X is the parent of the bookshelf. So bookshelf can deal with multiple resources which are been provided by the Google Cloud platform. Maybe they are dealing with the compute engine. Maybe they have to work with the networking facilities. Maybe they are dealing with the firewall rules. So accordingly, the projects are further being divided into resources. So what we have learned from this resource hierarchy is that the very first node, which is lying at the above, is the organization node, which is been followed by the folders. Folders are further been followed by the projects and further by the resources. So the idea here is that in cloud IAM, if organization node is having any sort of privileges been there or the policies which are being imposed at the organization node, those policies would be inherited by the child nodes too. So if department X is provided with the editor role and bookshelf project is only being provided with the viewer role. Now bookshelf is the child of the department X. So whatever the role is associated within the parent, that will directly be provided to the project too. So bookshelf can also be having the facility of the editor role in that. So normally within the resource hierarchy, it follows the principle of least privilege, which means that to any resource or to any role or to any identity, we should provide only the things which are required for them. Only the least privilege should be provided to the resources that we are looking for. This has been done just to provide more security or just to abstract the things from the other users. So let's discuss in detail about the organization node, which is also known as the root node in the GCP. Organization node basically deals with two kind of roles. First thing is it must be associated within the organization admin. So the organization admin has a control over all the cloud resources. So normally we are using this organization admin role for the auditing purposes. Then second one is the project creator role. Organization node can also be associated with this kind of role, where it controls the project creation, and also it controls over who can create the projects. So basically, within the project creator role, if it has been associated at the organization level, then the folders, further the projects, means all the child will itself been inherited with the project creator role. So there are some responsibilities of the organization node, which includes defining the IAM policies, determining the structure of the resource hierarchy, delegating the responsibilities over the critical components such as networking, then billing, who will handle the networking part, who will handle the billing part through the IAM rules. Second aspect, or the second object of the cloud IAM, is the folders, which provides the additional grouping mechanisms and also provides the isolation boundaries between the projects. So here, why we are using folders is that just to within an organization, there could be different legal identities or entities been there. Like one department was named as X in the examples, another one was the department Y. Or further, the folders can be divided into subfolders too. That department must be having some sort of teams dealing with certain issues associated within the department. So within a folder, there can be another subfolders been existing. Normally, folders allow the delegation of administration rights. Whatever the roles being associated with the folders, that will be fully restricted to those folders only. It should not be inherited by the another folders. So here I have given one example of the resource manager roles. Like for the organization node, we have learned that there is an admin role and there is a viewer role. Folders are provided with more roles, but as I said earlier, these are restricted to the folders only. So the folder can have the admin role, which can fully control the folders. It can have a creator role, which can browse the history of the folders and create the new folders. And third one is the viewer role, to view the folders and the projects which are lying below the any particular resource. The last one is the project. Project, we can create a project, we can delete a project. So we are having the two kind of roles been here, creator and deleter. So as mentioned earlier, from the organization till the project, the policies are inherited in the downward direction. The next one is the role. Roles play a vital role within cloud IAM. So broadly, there are three types of roles. One is primitive role, second one is predefined role, and third is the custom role. So if we talk about the primitive role, these can be applied across all the GCP resources within a project. So we are having a project. Whosoever resource is part of that project, we can provide the primitive role to them. So if we have to talk about the predefined role, as the name simplifies, predefined, these are already been defined, these are been managed by the Google. So we can apply the predefined role to any particular GCP service within a project. And if we have to talk about the custom roles, so custom roles can define a precise set of permissions. Custom roles like we are manually providing some sort of roles or set of permissions to any to view any specific resource. So we can use the custom roles there. So furthermore, primitive roles can further be divided as four types of the roles. One is the owner, then editor, then viewer, and the last one is the billing admin. So if we have to talk about the owner role, which can invite the members, which can delete the members, which can remove the members, the owner is associated with all these facilities, plus all the facilities which are associated within the editor role. Means an owner can do the invitation, can provide the, can remove the things, can delete the projects. Along with that, it can also be associated with the editor role. So furthermore, what has been presented within the editor role? Editors can modify the data, can deploy the applications or the services, and can configure the services. Plus, they can also be associated within the viewer roles. So viewer are the least privileged kind of resource, where we restrict the access to the users. They can only have the read-only access. Viewer can only view the resource. There is another kind of primitive role. We call it as a billing administration role, which is responsible for managing the billing or adding or removing the admins. Means all the things associated with the billing would be taken care of by the billing administration. So here I presented one more example, compute engine predefined IAM roles. This is part of the predefined IAM roles. As discussed earlier, we can provide predefined roles to a particular service. So a particular service taken here in this example is the compute engine. Compute engine can be associated with three types of the predefined roles. One is the compute admin role, which can have the full control of all the compute engine resources. Then it could also be associated with the network admin, which has the permissions to create a network, to modify and to delete the network resources, except they cannot handle the firewalls or SSL certificates. Then third one is the storage admin. So storage admin has the permissions to create, to modify, and to remove the disks or images, or as well as the snapshots. So compute engine is a kind of service upon which I can define some set of predefined roles. So these three are the predefined roles for the compute engine. Then is the last aspect, which is the members. Who can be represented as a member within a cloud IAM? So broadly, there are five members which can be considered here, which is Google account, service account, Google group, cloud identity, and GSuite domain. So Google account represents any developer or any administrator, or it could be any person who interact with the Google Cloud platform. So any email address which is associated with the Google account can be considered as an identity. So then is the service account. As the name implies, service. So it belongs to your service or your application rather than any individual end user. You can create as many service accounts as you wish to create for one specific application. Then third one is the Google group. Google group consists of the collection of your Google account as well as the service account. So when using the Google group, it is very convenient kind of procedure when you want to apply any sort of policy to a number of users. So we will be having a group, maybe it is a kind of Google account or it could be a service account. I want to impose any policy, I want to impose any role, then I can directly impose it at the Google group level so that it could be inherited by the all the resources which are part of it. Then third one is the GSuite domain. GSuite domain represents your organization's internet domain. Like here I have given one example that suppose your organization's internet domain is example.com. So when you add a user within GSuite domain, a new Google account is created for the user inside your own virtual group. So virtual group which could be named as user at the rate example.com. User could be the name of a user. He would be provided with the essential or credentials of the Google account with at the rate example.com. So next one is the cloud identity. So cloud identity is basically used for the people who don't have the privilege to access the G Suite resource. So here, GCP customers who are not G Suite customers can get the same capability in the cloud identity. So it basically helps in managing the users in groups using the Google Admin Console. So this is part of the cloud identity. So here is a one note been there. You cannot use the cloud IAM to create or manage the users. We are not managing the users here. We are managing the resources here. Okay. So G Suite and cloud identity can be used for managing this. Thanks so much for watching the cloud IAM video.